it is a little bit different. And also, this relies on not just you, your teammates. And some of these squads seem to be meshing really well together. You mentioned baby Nikki taking in all top three spots in every single final three. But you see brother Enoch and his team being so successful, getting more and more points each game, finding themselves in third spot. So,
well, the leaderboard at the top, so close as we're going into the back half. It's exactly what we want to see. It means it's more and more likely that the person who wins the final game will actually win the whole tournament, which is exactly what you want in a Battle Royale event. I want to talk, though, to one of the streamers, or maybe two of the streamers, who are competing in the event today and have a chance to get in that top spot. This is the Verizon player, Checkpoint, and we're going to go check in with his and hers live here. We do have both of them. Wonderful. Glad to see him here.
Let's go.
Andrew, Juga, thank you guys so much for taking the time to talk to us. Talk to me about game number one and like how that end circle went from your perspective.
Yeah, the game number one, it went really well for us at the end, but the beginning was really bad. We got sandwiched by two teams at Harvester and we had to do a full reset. Madness was the only one that survived with the Wraith. We looted Edge since we had nothing. We slowly went into end zone and we just got really lucky that we were running a Wraith instead of a Valkyrie because we've been going back and forth between the two. And yeah, Madness with the Wraith. We ported in a little bit. We went back and forth, got some loot on the in circle there. The teams were coming in around us, and we were just kind of holding a rock with some Cossack traps. Lots of shots coming in, but we just had a rock that we were holding. Luckily, there was a team on the roof right next to us, and they were putting a lot of pressure on us, but they got third-partied a little bit. It allowed us to breathe a little bit, and then we recovered, and last circle was a bubble fight. We got some good damage in, but then Madness clutched it out for us in the end with the Eva. So that's why we have him on the team.
Yeah, for sure there. I mean, did you know you were going up against Imperial Howl during that final circle? And more broadly, does knowing you're going up against professional Apex players like get in your head at all?
I mean, it makes you really, really focus. And it also, the one thing that you do in these lobbies is you don't peek for too long. Basically, there's one or two people on every team that can instantly delete you. So, yeah, it's definitely, it puts a lot of pressure on you. And it just, you have to adjust the way you play and the way that you peek any shots.
Guys, I got a question. It's unrelated to your play, but how the heck are you here? How did you take a break from throwing all the tournaments you guys throw in the Apex of the community? I mean, every day you guys have a tournament going on. Just a little bit about what you guys do for the community and the fact that you know are really great at putting on these events that everyone seems to love.
No, it's been super fun. We're supposed to have a tournament right now, the BFC Pro Tournament, but we did it yesterday instead to make space for this, which we love to play in.
A military tomorrow.
Yeah, we have a military tournament tomorrow where everyone in there is going to be veterans or active duty. So that's super cool. We're excited about it. But yeah, it's just something that we really enjoy. Our community is huge, and they play Apex, and they're we love them, so we like to throw tournaments so that everybody can play. Even the pro players, I mean, we adore them as well, so we like to try to get involved with what they're doing. So from the pro players to the just grinders, we just enjoy the whole thing. And it's been a lot of fun for us. I mean, we spend a lot of time doing it, obviously. So if it wasn't fun, we wouldn't do it. So we just really enjoy it, and we really appreciate everybody.
But it's fun to be on the other side and for you to play in one. So
yeah, it is. It's a lot of fun to play, too. I mean, we're pretty good at the game, so it is fun.
It's really nice to be able to see you guys pop off in your own regards as players, but also thank you guys so much for everything that you guys do for the community. You guys are such a necessary staple here, and it's amazing everything
that you guys do. We appreciate you.
And still have time to compete. Oh, thank you guys. But you know what? Going forward and looking at the competition, World's Edge, that's it. It's off the table. Now we're going on to Olympus. Do you guys have any game-changing plans now as we're going to change maps?
Yeah, so we're running Caustic, Gibraltar, Wraith, and we're thinking about Caustic isn't the best on Olympus. We're thinking about we could possibly switch.